Alumni CONNECT, podcast, ki uspešne zgodbe alumnov ekonomske fakultete pripelje med vas. Ne zamudi in se pokonektaj z nami.
Welcome to the second Alumni CONNECT podcast. School of Economics and Business Ljubljana has been connecting students internationally for many years. Therefore, we will have this conversation in English. Today's guest is Teja Burja, Digital Marketing Manager from Adidas headquarters in Germany. She will tell us about her career path, she will talk about the working environment in Germany, and also she will give us some career advice. So, as we say in Adidas, impossible is nothing. We are both here at the same time while working in Germany otherwise. I'm super happy. And we're here to talk about working in sport brand industry, specifically Adidas. And Teja, tell me, how did you find yourself in a small town of Herzogenaurach? This big in Germany. How did you find yourself there?
Yeah, interesting question. Firstly, thank you for having me. Really glad to be back at the university. Feels weird but exciting at the same time. But yeah, how it all started. Actually, I was applying for the internship at Adidas. I just saw that they were looking for someone at the brand communication area, and I was like, sounds interesting, and it's Adidas. Let me see, let me apply, and then have no expectations, and then see where that goes. So then I applied, went through all the interview rounds, and they offered me the internship. And I was checking the location, and I was thinking, okay, it's Germany. It's like quite far away. I think I'm gonna stay there for 6 months, but then also get a good reference, and then return back to Slovenia. But yeah, obviously that didn't happen, as we are now here and both working for Adidas still.
Totally understand, but how did you manage to make a difference that they chose you out of probably hundreds of different applicants?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not sure what was the exact like reason. I just said that, I mean, when I was applying, I really came there with like zero, I mean, no expectations, no pressure. I was really just very communicative, open, and like ready for a new challenge. Probably also my background from like doing a lot of sports helped with that, and my past experiences working in marketing areas in advertising agency. But yeah, apart from that, I think it was, yeah, not sure what really convinced them. But definitely when I got there, I felt like, oh, it's a great team, great spirit. I really felt like I'm fitting in there.
That sounds amazing. I think my path was quite the same, like applying with no expectations, ending up there and staying.
Yeah.
It's quite crazy. And I wanted to ask as well, how do you feel working in such a big company? Like, it's way different probably from your past experience. You said you were working in an agency. What's the difference? How would you compare?
Yeah, I mean, it's at the same, like it's different, but also same, right? Some areas are like, oh, you're working for Adidas. Even sometimes I forget about it, that it's like such a huge brand. And then my friend would tell me, please never stop working for Adidas. I love just saying to people, I have a friend that works for Adidas. And I find that really funny. And also sometimes, you know it, when you're walking around the campus and you're like, wow, it's like great infrastructure and all the people around, it's like hard to even like take it in or imagine it if you're not there. But on the other hand, it's marketing projects, it's briefing, it's all the concept creative things that we were doing at the agency as well. It's just from a different angle, because before I was involved in different industry, and now you're on a client side. So just very focused on a sport brand industry and our own guidelines.
Great. And you have been there for 5 years already, right? So what made you stay for so long?
Yeah, so I mean, I can't believe it's almost 5 years now. As I said, I applied for internship and really thought I'm gonna stay here for 6 months and then come back home. I don't know, like another opportunity came in when our digital manager at that time resigned, And my director approached me and she was like, would you be interested in digital marketing career? And I was like, I'm not sure I can do that, but sounds tempting for sure. And I was ready for a new challenge. And then on the other hand, also the whole benefits of the campus and the mindset of the people and the international spirit, those are all the good things that you can't really find in any firm, right? We don't take that for granted, but it's definitely something that makes you stay and makes your kind of next step in the career, like leaving the company, for example, much, much harder. That's why I definitely didn't know I'm going to stay for that long, but all those factors really helped to get.
Yeah, I totally understand because I also started as an intern and it just happened that opportunities just pop when you're there. It's way easier to stay there and you just don't say no for such opportunities. So I feel like you just stay there and time flies and, oh, I'm here for 5 years, what? So totally understand. And also all the benefits that you mentioned. For example, I really like the flexible working time, starting quite whenever and finishing quite whenever. It's just important to be there on the right meetings and to finish tasks in deadlines, right? So this is one of the things that like really is super important for me. But what would you say that are other benefits that Adidas offers that you really like and have value for you?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, one thing, just to go back to the flexi hours, I never thought before that it's even possible to have a job where you can't be late for work. It's like you organize your time. I mean, it's important that you're available for the meetings, but still there is no pressure and no like micromanaging from that point of view. And I think, our generation and like all even younger generations really appreciate that flexibility aspect of the working environment. And then other benefits, there are plenty. Definitely a lot of sport opportunities that the campus itself is offering. You know it. We have a climbing wall in the middle of the campus. Other areas. You can do boxing or yoga during lunch breaks. You can just walk around with your sport bag and just hoodies. No one is going to look at you like, what's wrong with you? Just like, exactly. Okay, I want to join you for a workout. So I think also that healthy spirit in a way, because you have so many opportunities to keep active and so many colleagues that are even helping you to stay in the form or like just try different sports you have never even heard of or like did before.
Exactly, I totally agree. I also think the canteen offers healthy options. That's one of the things that's also super important for me. And another thing that I've noticed is I came home wearing Adidas stuff, but a bit baggy, a bit like sporty. And my dad was like, I really hope you don't go to work like that. And I'm like, Dad, my boss comes like this, you know? And it's very, very somehow calm and chill environment. You can be who you are. And this connection to sport, everyone is connected to sport. That's, I think, one of the really important things there. Which makes us a company.
A company,
And a company culture, right?
Yeah, for sure. You can definitely feel it there. And as you said, I mean, when I joined Adidas, I had a lot of blazers and blouses and like really fancy stuff in my closet. And then almost all of that just stayed untouched since I joined. Just because it's so normal that you just come there in a very cozy outfit and in very like casual dress code. Apart from wearing a competitor's brand. So,
definitely. <yeah. laughs> There has been so many stories when people just somehow came in some competitor brands and it wasn't really nice. Definitely. And okay, you mentioned you started as an intern and then it just happened that they offered you an assistant position, which is basically an entry level. But now you're a manager. How did this promotion happen? How does it happen in such big companies? Is it always the same or how do people get promoted?
Yeah, I think it varies a lot on basically team by team base, project by project, and it really depends on your line manager, because I had a really good relationship with my director. So she was really fighting for me and appreciating all the work that I did. And with that also offered me the promotion. But end of the day, I think it's that appreciation of the senior leadership to see the hard work and like your progress going beyond what's in your job description, and just being super collaborative and curious at the same time. Just learn from, like, there are so many experts around you, and then you just kind of need to inject all of that knowledge and then build your own opinions, but then with that also grow a lot. So I think it was a combination of things, but definitely a hard work and a motivation. You need to show that eagerness, and then for sure it's going to be seen and promoted. Sometimes it just takes a bit of time, because we are always so focused on what's next, what's coming, and just not just being like, okay, I'm here, it's actually okay, it's a good step, right? But yeah, somehow you also sometimes just need to learn how to be a bit patient when it comes to career, but also any life decisions or stages.
Yeah, I definitely agree. All this eagerness, working beyond what's needed, definitely. But then also in these big companies, what I have noticed is also there is a budget and there's headcount, and if they really, really want you, they can push for it. But mm-hmm. sometimes it just isn't possible, which is sometimes frustrating, can be frustrating. But as we can see, you have really showed skills, passion, and this is how everything is possible. Nothing is impossible, okay. Right? So I totally agree on how you explained that. So if we move to your current role, what do you actually do? How does your day look at the job? Is it always the same? Maybe it's a bit more periodical, or explain us a bit what you do.
Yeah, I think periodical, it's a good word that you that you mentioned. Sometimes it feels like a roller coaster when you start your day and you thought, okay, that's my schedule, like that's the agenda, I know what I'm gonna be doing, but then things can get like pretty messy, or like there are any like changes which are quite constant, but I like it. I would never want to be in the environment when everything is kind of set and like just, you know, a practice is there and there's no way to change things. So for me also, I mean, as a digital like marketing manager, I think a lot of times that differs on what different digital marketing managers do in their daily job. But for my specific role, it's a mix of like working with digital analytics, looking at how our campaigns are performing, then briefing the agencies, creating new concepts, to then pre-production stage of like planning for the photo shoots, attending the photo shoots, and then making sure that whatever it's produced then gets translated into our digital system, just dressing our website into our creatives and designing the different tools for the app and the CRM and all the paid media tools. So it's a very diverse in a way, but as I said, I really enjoy that it's also always evolving in a way, because it's digital. We always are gonna have like new builds on the website, there's always going to be something new, or compared to like last year's campaigns to this year, the scope just gets bigger. It's just growing, and you are growing with that, just expanding your knowledge in maybe some channels you like didn't even know they existed or how to use them, right? As I said, I enjoy working in that environment, so just keeping it more life in a way.
Sounds super interesting. Maybe I would like to know a bit more into detail. How does briefing look like for the people that don't work in marketing yet? How would you describe that? What do you actually do?
Yeah, for sure. I think also that differs on a level on like in which industry you're working, but I'm gonna speak about my example. how we are briefing the agency, we would always look at, on one hand, analytics. So basically, how were the things performing last year, and then looking at what are recommendations and conclusions out of that. We would also look at, just making sure we have a consumer-centric approach. So what does it mean that our campaign is going to be a consumer-centric? We can find that out with the different consumer analysis, looking at example. Now I'm working on a Christmas campaign. Just firstly speak with the consumer, having that in-depth interviews, understand where are they looking for inspiration for Christmas gifts, which channels are the most applicable, what would they find as a good ad versus maybe something that it's not that tempting for them. So just understand from their end what really connects or drives them. And then on the other hand, we have our, it's Adidas, it's a global brand, so we have our brand guidelines. We need to stick to somehow some directions just to ensure that Adidas as a brand is looking the same regardless on which campaign we are working on. So we take all of that and then brief it to the agency, also speaking about what's the budget, what's the timings, and also explaining the scope and expectations. And from there, we would go into then building the concept, looking at what's going to be our campaign narrative. And when we align on that and the messaging, then we go into more specific channel builds. And with that, this is where our digital areas are then also coming to life on what are we going to do on the website? What are we going to do? Is there any specific we are going to have on like other channels? Is there a new build on the app or anything that hasn't been done before? And we pack all of that up and then plan for the photo shoot to ensure that whatever we are shooting for, we are going to get that throughout our digital production and then can use it on all the different channels. And also making sure it's going to be fit for purpose on a channel. So just saying that not everything is going to be working on like various touch points. And consider all of that. Yeah, I know your question was about a brief, so now I expanded.
I understand everything is very connected. As you were mentioning, you work with agencies, you probably work with many other different teams. Maybe you could tell us a bit more about who you work with?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, so, I mean, key partner, definitely, as I said, digital analytics, to really get the numbers, to see what's working, what's not working, what has some potential, but maybe it's not activated in a way that it should be, or where are the opportunities, definitely. And on the other hand, with the product teams, merchandising, what are going to be our collections, and with markets on what do they want to activate, what are they ranging, but also what are any specific needs on a market level that we can take and like kind of cater to that from a global point of view. And then I'm also working very closely with the newsrooms. Those are our social teams, such as like Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and also with UX, just looking at how is our digital journey gonna come together on various touch points. And at the end with the content planning team, they're the team planning all the content and all the deliverables that are gonna be sitting on our various touch points, because as you know, it can become very complex, so they're really helping us to keep everything organized and in shape to ensure that whenever we come to the agency, it's already like very structured, or at least as much as it can be.
Yeah, definitely, it's a huge company and there are many stakeholders that you need to somehow align. Would you say that you also work with retail and marketing and retail marketing?
Yeah, I mean, we are working as a comms team, so meaning that whatever we do we should first look through the concept, like through the what's the media neutral idea that's gonna work on all the different channels. So with that, we also need to ensure that the retail teams are involved. Maybe something that's working on digital, it's not working like one-to-one in retail. Also in retail, you have the products in there, you can touch it, you can feel it, versus in digital, you really need to put that extra effort and focus on the product, because that's the only space where the consumer is going to see it. And then on the other hand, also connect the dots with like digital retail, like digital windows, or just leading from, example, emails, leading to what's your closest like store where you can shop that product. So in that regards, yeah, we are very connected, and just, yeah, making sure that the whole journey, it's holistic, because we also know it's not just a digital consumer or a retail consumer. It's like everyone's gonna see all the different ads at the different point in times, right?
Definitely, everything has to be aligned.
Yeah.
And you also mentioned that as you're working in digital, it is developing super fast. You have to keep with trends. How do you keep up with trends, and where do you source new ideas?
Yeah, so I would say, like, I definitely lean to the like different supports from different teams, looking at, for example, just like TikTok, right? We are including that as a channel for our campaigns and trying to integrate it. I definitely wasn't the fast, I would say, like, one of the first consumers of that app, but definitely more the follower. However, then when we see we need more knowledge or really understanding on who's that like TikTok consumer, what's the content that resonates there, then we are really leaning towards the partners, having TikTok, like people from the TikTok coming in, presenting, consulting, and like getting the practices from their end. Similarly, we had a workshop last week with Pinterest team, just, yeah, taking the learnings from their end, helping us to enhance the creative to make sure it's gonna fit to their platform. So because we are such a huge brand, I think that's the advantage where you can really partner up, right,
with
different brands, different channels, so to ensure that whatever then you activate, it already includes their knowledge and expertise.
That sounds super interesting, I have to say. I have been on a workshop as well. We have been at headquarters of High Snobiety, so they are very relevant for European market. And we had such an interesting workshop learnings out of it that I think this is super, super important that you actually connect and partner up with the stakeholders you work with.
Yeah.
Definitely. And you said you source information from them, but also you have been educating here at School of Economics and Business Ljubljana. And I would like to ask you, what have you learned here that helps you now at your current job?
Yeah, I mean, I think like marketing as a kind of subject at school, it's very broad, but it gives you a wider understanding. However, as we were speaking before, we said that you learn something at school, it can be heard in a very like theoretical way, but then marketing job is always gonna differ based on the company and the position you're working in, right? So for me, what I learned, and especially in the IMB program where I joined for the master studies, it was theoretical, but also just for me was one of big learnings. It was how does it become, like, how does it get activated, or how some companies are using the knowledge in a very, yeah, not in theory, but like in practice, right? So this is something what I learned when we were working very, yeah, on hands with actual companies, not just reading the case studies, and how you can apply the knowledge into then a very practical situation. And also teamwork. I mean, here it was so important to like collaborate and like bring the project to life together. And because also, as we were saying, it's a huge brand, you're never gonna have all the information and inputs on your hand, but just knowing who you need, who you can talk with, for me also just, yeah, being able to kind of get everyone together and create great things together, it's also a good skill, I would say. And then marketing as a subject, when I was studying, there was no digital marketing like as a subject in place yet, right? So also I would see it as a more freshly baked on like as a job, right? So I learned a lot of things at work. What does digital marketing means? And I would say also for me, working on a global level is also meaning something different than than for someone working on a market level, right? So yeah. It's also then just like forever evolving, and then making sure that wherever you end up in this field, you're just open, curious, and then understand the different aspects of it.
Okay, it's a great explanation. I see your job as marketing and also kind of managerial. Yes, you are a marketing manager, and I think this managerial part was definitely learned here somehow, gathering the team together, as you said, and as you mentioned, working in a team. I think this is super important, how you fit in a team. Mm-hmm. You are on the job for 8 hours a day, and you're collaborating with your closest team all the time, basically. And I would like to ask you, how is your team like? How would you describe it? And who do you really appreciate having around, and why?
As I said, I mean, I am a team player. So for me, it's really important to feel good in the environment, and then just be surrounded with colleagues that you have a good kind of relationship with, right? So I would say also that we were speaking about that as well, but like that international connection and collaboration, it's really important, and I see that a lot of different ideas comes from like different cultural backgrounds. Our team is very diverse. It's like someone from US, someone from India, someone from Germany, just like different parts of the world, but somehow we all like work together in a very good way. And my line manager is the one that I would be always looking at to like, because he's a very good like comms expert. So I learn a lot from him, and what I really really appreciate that he's always there for the support, but like never like micromanaging. So I know that whenever I need him, he's gonna be there, but he also knows that I'm doing my project, he's trusting me. So as long as all of that is connected, there is no need to, any like extra pressure or too many meetings sometimes, or like too many alignments, but just to make sure you're on the same page, and then having that trust in people that they're gonna, and empowerment. And this is something that I'm definitely getting from my team. So really, I'm really happy with where I ended up.
I totally agree with the team, that it's super important for you, as you can learn from everyone from your team, especially if they are from different parts of the world. This adds great value, I would say. And you were also mentioning that you work on your own projects, and your line manager is just checking if everything is going well. And what kind of projects are you working with? When are the campaigns launching? What's the purpose of such campaigns? Are the campaigns every year at the same time? You mentioned the Christmas campaign, probably you work on that every year. Are there also campaigns that are just popping? This is something new, or how does that work?
Yeah, so definitely we have a calendar in place. So we are looking at what's launching at what time and what's important for the consumer. We know that everyone's shopping, almost everyone is shopping during Christmas or like during the holidays period. So we want to ensure that we have that communication there, and making sure that we give some inspiration when they're looking for gifts to consider Adidas as a brand to give to their family and friends. But then also every year the timeline can be changing slightly, right? So from when I started, our holiday campaign was starting sometime in November and then ending in December. Now it evolves, and it's like starting in October and then ending only with January, already with the story of like having something new for the year, right? More not about gifting others, but also gifting yourself. So we have a, like, as I said, timeline, yes, it's in place. But we also have a lot of then, just leave the space for also some freedom, or if we see that extra content is needed, we produce it. And then, as I said, it's forever evolving. We also put now during the pandemic, right, a lot of stores were closed. So we just made sure that in digital, we produce even more to make sure that we can help to kind of close the gap a bit, and just push the e-com, the traffic to the e-com store even further.
How would you say this COVID situation affected your team? Because you have been there before and during and now after, hopefully. How would you say these periods differed?
Yeah, I mean, it was for me like on a day-to-day basis, because it was because it's digital marketing and we were working a lot online before, it was a very quick transition. I definitely missed more of like one-to-ones and like in-person interaction. Mm-hmm. However, job-wise, like work-wise, everything happened quite smoothly, the whole transition. The only thing was that we also had a kind of the team like reorganization during the COVID time. So yeah, also one of my colleagues, I was working with him online for I think almost like 6 months, and then I was able to meet him in person. So that was a bit like an interesting situation. But because I was there already before, for me it wasn't such a huge it wasn't that hard. It wasn't that challenging. It was also quite a quick transition versus someone that would be onboarding to a new role, which I can say definitely. Probably in your case it was a bit different, right?
Yeah, definitely. It's totally different. Also because, as you said, digital is already digital. A lot of roles moved from offline to online, and I think that's why yours was kind of less
impacted.
Exactly. And so there are some challenges at work, of course, and one of them was this COVID situation. But what are some other challenges that are not connected to COVID?
In my like daily. So we are facing a lot of kind of challenges when it comes to the product, because we are trying to look at the concepts and create something that works for the whole globe. But then you have, for sure, different markets, different needs on their markets, trying to cater to their consumers. And somehow you end up with trying to cater to all, but like those asks are so different that you really can't. So then you just need to prioritize, like, what can you do and what is just like a nice to have, or you need to drop it, right? So also for product, it's a very general, I would say, example. For Christmas campaign, we have like one part of the globe that's gonna have winter at that time, and they really wanna have like winter jackets in the campaigns and like really cozy sweaters. And then you have like the other hemisphere when you're like, yeah, if it's a winter jacket, we won't like launch it because like we just need shorts. you as a like wearing a global hat, you need to find a way that works for all. And challenges, it's hard to think of examples, but it's always something. As I said, like it's a very like quickly changing environment. So I think one challenge is to accept that whatever you were planning for and already putting sometimes a lot of efforts in, maybe it's gonna be switched around to a completely different direction, and then tomorrow it's gonna be your like day one starting on the campaign, even almost like from zero, right? And you shouldn't be too frustrated about it, but just like, okay, that's the situation, it's for the good, let's put all the kind of efforts into that.
Totally. And me, from a market perspective, I totally understand the first challenge that you said. Every market wants something for themselves, and I'm here from Europe like, We need that. Could you please provide? But sometimes it just needs to be scalable. It needs to reach some limits that you can work on it. So totally understand your challenge. But also, what would you say were your biggest learnings at the job?
Yeah, so I think because I started in Adidas when I was, it was one of my first jobs after the graduation. So I really learned how things are happening in practice, and also how in such a big firm, how you're trying to navigate, how like through different departments, and then just trying to see the bigger picture on how it all comes together. And for me, all the expertise that I learned from specifically digital marketing area, I learned at that job. And this is also something that I wanna continue with and definitely stay in the field of digital marketing, potentially bring that at some point to maybe other departments or other industries, and just expand my knowledge also in that different areas.
Okay, so as we already hear about looking a bit into the future, what are your plans? What are your next steps in the career? Do you have any idea?
Yeah, I'm not trying to plan too much, especially now we saw during the pandemic, everything that you had planned, nothing happened in that way, which is why I really try to keep it more spontaneous and then just follow kind of my instincts and areas. I mean, people that know me, they know that I'm quite obsessed and like very passionate about outdoor, and then just spending time outside ski touring or mountaineering. And this is also some area where I would potentially see myself like looking at, like from the work perspective, maybe ending in the outdoor business unit or any other outdoor brand, because this is where my passion lies, and I think this is something that drives me. So it would be great to connect outdoor and maybe something with sustainability, because it's also one of my kind of personal goals and very important value for me, so to connect something in that area. But as I said, I'm gonna let myself be surprised and then always keep telling, like, you're gonna end up where you need to be, even if you at the moment have like no idea how that's gonna look.
Definitely, you have kind of already answered my next and my last question. So as someone who just finished university and you find your first job and you're super excited about it, but then you're like, is that it? Is that something I want? Should your first job be something that you're really passionate about it? Or does passion come from something that you're good at? So you start your first job, for example, and you somehow grow, as you said, you learned a lot there, you expanded your knowledge in digital marketing, and somehow you became passionate about it. Would you say you were already passionate about what you do right now before? Or did it somehow develop and you also found this passion in outdoor sports and you're going to combine two passions? How would you say this passion topic combines with work?
Yeah, I'm definitely not a good example of, or like an example of saying like my first job would be something that I would always wanted to do. I was always, before I came to Adidas, I was doing a lot of different student jobs, exploring different areas, sometimes even being like, just please hire me, like I just want to get experiences, right? I didn't know where I'm gonna be good at, or like what exactly do I want to do. I was even studying finance at IMB, but I knew I just want to get like that finance perspective, even though I was always interested in marketing, but I wanted to get that like marketing knowledge in practice. So I was jumping like from one job to another, to like the Erasmus exchange, and like to then different career spots, right? And then when I came to Adidas, I really felt, after my internship, because at my internship I also thought it's just gonna be 6 months, I was like, maybe like this is something where I really belong, because I just felt it was job for sure, like the job and all the advantages and knowledge, but it was also the environment. So I think it's also a mix of all of those different factors coming together. It's something you're good at, you're like passionate about, you become like, you build expertise to do that. But then also, yeah, the environment, the colleagues, leadership, all of that kind of has to come in place that you're gonna feel it like, oh, okay, like maybe I didn't expect that to happen or to stay abroad for that long. But then all of those factors also helped me to just become so passionate about the brand, even when I'm outside of the working hours, right? I would be always like, why are you wearing another brand? So somehow it's now part of my, like, yeah, part of me. And also what I was really, yeah, appreciating, it gave me so many opportunities to also, yeah, change me to be like more, even more sporty and try so many like different sports. But at the same time also just stay there and take more and more project onwards and build my knowledge and also network, which at the end it's super important. But I would just say, don't stress too much about what's the first job, how long am I gonna stay, what's next, just like go for it and don't be afraid to change, because maybe just that, yeah, changing also from any experience you're gonna get something. Maybe even you're gonna get a sense of, maybe that's not for me, right? But that's also good, because then you know that in the next role, in the next job, you're gonna be like, oh, but that's different, right? And that's something I was striving for. So yeah, I would just say, go for it and like, don't be too limited or, yeah, too scared or like just ready to get to the routine too quickly.
Amazing. I think this perspective of trying different things, getting different perspectives, really helps you in any role that you at the end choose, because you have different point of views and different kind of knowledge, which definitely helps in anything you do. So
yeah,
this diversity, I think it's very, very, very valuable. Thank you very much. Thank you for being with me. I learned a lot, and I'm happy that we finally met in person. And thank you, School of Economics and Business Ljubljana, for hosting us. Yes.
Thank you so much. That was fun.